In this brief video, I'll demonstrate how to enable Windows Sandbox on a Windows 11 Professional or Windows 11 Enterprise system. So here I have Windows 11 Professional in this computer. Now at this point, to enable Sandbox, we need to go and add this as a feature under the program feature. So just type in the search window, enable features, and then click here on turn Windows features on and off, and then scroll all the way to the bottom. Select Windows Sandbox and then click OK. Once installed, it will prompt you to restart your computer, and you want to go ahead and restart it. Once you have restarted the computer, you should be able to launch it by either locating it under the list of programs or simply click on search and type Windows Sandbox. Now, Windows Sandbox is a separate Windows environment on top of the host operating system for Windows 11 Professional or Windows 11 Enterprise. It's not available for Windows Home. Now, here we can maximize this and we can use this for testing, whether it's to test links from a website or to test applications, and it will not impact, none of these settings will stay with the virtual machine after you close that session. So it's designed to be a secure area for you to test software or to test various applications. So here is an example. So this will basically function just like a regular Windows 11. We can open here a browser, and I'll demonstrate by installing, let's say, TeamViewer. So we install the application, it doesn't matter what it is. Now that I have TeamViewer installed on the Sandbox, once I close the Sandbox application, it will erase all settings and everything that was added from the last time that I launched it. So we click OK here. Now if we go back and open Sandbox again, this will start with a brand new session with clean setup. Now, Windows Sandbox also has the option where you can copy files from your host machine's desktop or any of the file locations and bring those files back to the Sandbox by copying and pasting them. So let's say I have this file here. I'll copy it. Go and open the Sandbox. And I can simply right-click here and choose paste. Here's another example where you might have to check out a game or something of that nature, and you're going to all of these different websites, but you want to test it first on the Sandbox. So you go to that particular website and you try to download it. And as you know, with any of the free games out there, it's going to download a lot of junk in your computer. So now if we go ahead and run this, it's going to download who knows how many other things to our computer. Notice it's coming up with free ride games and then Solitaire Kingdom. So now let's suppose that this is not the game that we really want. Notice it has added all kinds of other stuff here. I've come to the determination that this is not really the game that I want. If I wanted something, I can go ahead and install it in the host machine. But now if I go ahead and close this, it's going to quit all the stuff that I downloaded. And now if I go and open the Sandbox again, it'll be a fresh start again. And my host system, the main one where I'm running the Sandbox, none of that is impacted. So this is one of the good uses of Windows Sandbox, is basically to test software, test URLs that might look suspicious before you run them on your main production machine.